Welcome to the release highlights for Okta's Workforce Identity Cloud. We will go over new generally available features and early access new features. Generally available features. Okta LDAP Agent version 5.19.1 and Okta Active Directory Agent version 3.16.1. These versions of the agents contain fixes to the expiring signature error that prevented agents from auto-updating to the newest version. Unknown devices detection using fingerprint. Admins can now configure how unknown devices are treated based on the presence of a device fingerprint. Granular permissions to manage directories. This feature enables you to assign permissions to view and manage directories as part of a customized admin role. Admins without universal application administrator permissions can handle directory-specific tasks. Stay signed in. Today, Keep Me Signed In allows the user to select whether their multi-factor authenticators from previous sessions should be remembered. However, the option to select Keep Me Signed In was only available on the sign-in screen. To enable Stay Signed In for integrated authentication flows, admins can now configure their sign-in experience such that the option to stay signed in is provided either before the user signs into Okta or before and after the user completes multi-factor authentication. If a user selects stay signed in, they won't be challenged for MFA the next time they sign in. In addition, users will now be able to sign out of all active Okta sessions from the Okta end user dashboard. Enhanced system log event. The Policy Evaluate Sign-On System Log event now shows the assurance policy factor requirement and a list of the available authentication factors for the sign-on event. Verify Zoom users with Okta. Zoom users can now attest and verify a user's identity between two independent parties using Okta-signed tokens. Dynamic User Schema Discovery now available. Dynamic User Schema Discovery is now available for SCIM app integrations that support user entitlements and identity governance. OIN connector support for entitlement management. The PagerDuty and Zendesk connectors have been updated to support entitlement management. App integration tile now available for Okta Workflows. Users who are assigned the Okta Workflows app integration now have a dedicated tile on their end-user dashboard to launch the Okta Workflows console. API setting now an admin console option. The Use Persistent Name ID Higher Security checkbox allows more secure account linking. This setting allows Okta to determine the associated user account by matching the name ID with the external ID. When no match is found, Okta uses the IDP username value for account matching. New action items for self-service upgrades. The OIE Upgrade Hub displays action items if orgs have non-writable attributes in their self-service registration policy or a factor enrollment policy set to Do Not Enroll. Super Admin Role now required to update direct authentication grants. Super Admin permissions are now required to enable or change direct authentication grants for clients. Let's wrap up with a look at early access features. Okta Personal for Workforce. Okta Personal for Workforce is a set of features that allows admins to separate their end users' work data from non-work data. Admins can now offer their end users a free Okta Personal account to store personal data, allow them to switch between the accounts, and migrate personal apps from Okta Enterprise Tenant to Okta Personal. When Okta Personal for Workforce is enabled, personalized comms will be sent to the end users encouraging them to use Okta Personal for personal data and Okta Enterprise for work data. Content Security Policy for Custom Domains. The Content Security Policy feature lets admins control which URLs may be linked from customized sign-in and error pages in orgs that use custom domains. Admins add trusted URLs to Okta that link to items such as images and add these links to the code in their sign-in and error pages. This feature enhances security by enabling admins to allow only approved content to appear and prevent the introduction of potentially malicious code to these pages. Protected Actions in the Admin Console. The Protected Actions feature provides an additional layer of security to your org. It prompts admins for authentication when they perform critical tasks in the admin console and helps ensure that only authorized admins can perform these tasks. Super admins can configure the authentication interval for their org. SAML Certificate Expiration Notification feature. This feature notifies admins through task entries in the admin console about expired or soon-to-expire certificates for SAML apps. This enhances security and minimizes app downtime caused by expired certificates. Detect and block requests from anonymizing proxies. Orgs can now detect and block web requests that come from anonymizers. This helps improve the overall security of your org. Support for Active Directory password complexity requirements. This feature creates an option in the password policy to match the same complexity options as Active Directory. Until now, admins couldn't exactly match Okta password complexity requirements to those of their AD instances. Historically, the password complexity requirements in Okta and AD had different granularities, and the requirements displayed in the sign-in widget didn't always reflect the AD requirements. As a result, users were locked out without proper error messages. This feature bridges that gap. Custom languages for email templates. Admins can now customize Okta-generated emails in any BCP47 formatted language. Previously, customizations were limited to 27 Okta-supported languages. This feature allows admins to configure additional locales using the Okta's Brands API. When a new locale is configured, it is available as a new language selection within the email templates editor. Dynamic OS version compliance for device assurance. You can configure OS version compliance by using device assurance. However, you have to manually update the policies every time a new OS version or patch is released. With dynamic OS version compliance, Okta updates device assurance policies with the latest OS versions and patches, eliminating the need for manual updates. With this feature, you can ensure OS version compliance in your org without tracking OS releases. Prevent new single-factor access to the admin console. This feature prevents admins from configuring any new single-factor access to the admin console. There's no impact to any existing rules that allow single-factor access. Thanks for viewing the release highlights for Okta's Workforce Identity Cloud. For additional details, please visit the Okta release notes and product note links, which can be found in the video description.